Greetings. I wanted to just generate an impromptu video here. I read and saw some things on the internet recently about a comet that people were claiming was going to, plunge us into 3 days of darkness this Rash Ha Shannah, which is late September. And I think that's a little bit of fear-mongering. There is available on the internet a website from the Jet Propulsion Lab, ssd.jpl.nasa.gov. And there you can find a JPL small body database browser. Basically, it allows you to play with and demonstrate the orbital dynamics of objects in space for which they understand the ephemeris. See, they understand through calculations, through physics, and through math, all of these values predicting the paths of objects. It allows you to look at the view from different perspectives. Here you can flatten things out and you can see, okay, it's not, the comet's not exactly in the plane of the solar system. This represents the orbits of the solar system. You can turn off the planet labels if you want. You can turn off the date label in the corner here, but I think the date label is the important thing to pay attention to. And you can zoom. What I think is kind of interesting to look at is, let's focus on the orbits of Earth. Earth down here. And here's the comet passing through. This blue line is the comet's trajectory through our solar system. Here we are on August 7th. And I'm going to step through an hour at a time and just let it play. Okay, more than that, I'm going to step it a day at a time just to get it close. So here we are. By August 19th, it's inside the orbit of Venus. And I'm just going to rotate this a little bit. And if you notice, there's a nice axis line here. And you'll see that about the time that the Earth is on this axis, the comet is likewise passing through the axis. So somewhere roughly September 25th, the comet is going to finally be in line with the Earth. Now, to think that this is going to somehow occlude the sun, or think that it's going to cause an eclipse, and the stories that I've seen on the web say it's going to be an eclipse for 3 days of darkness, just doesn't make sense. The moon, which isn't whipping by us at the same speed, when it has an eclipse, the eclipse lasts about an hour. So the fact that this comet, being much smaller than the moon, being much further away than the moon. See, the moon's orbit is too small to even show on this picture. It is so tight to the Earth. This inner white line here, that's the orbit of Venus. Think how far away the planet Venus is. Here's something much smaller than Venus, much smaller than the moon, and it's further away. This won't even barely be visible as a dot passing in front of the sun, but it certainly is not going to cause an eclipse. But comets cast tails. And as the comet's tail, which follows, it always seems to trail a little bit, because as things blow out from the comet, they form a tail, and that tail is going to have a delayed arc. So we won't even enter the comet's tail at this point. But I think as you go through October, maybe the comet's tail. Now we're at October 9th, October 10th. The comet is going to leave some debris. Now, is it going to leave it in the plane of the Earth? It's kind of too close to tell at this point. It may be higher than the Earth's orbit. Let's go back to looking just from the top. But as we keep going, somewhere around October 18th, 19th, 20th, the comet is going to pass through the Earth's orbital path. And comets leave debris behind. Comets are flaking off little specks and dots and dirt and dust as they fly through space, and as the solar wind creates the tail by blowing off this trail of debris. So I think somewhere between October 20th and earlier, maybe October 10th, 7th, the debris tail from the comet that is blowing out may cause elements to be blown out into the trajectory that the Earth is going to be passing through over the next week. So we're not going to get hit with this comet Elenin, but we may pass through its tail. Will there be so much debris that it causes days of darkness? I don't think so. I think that's kind of laughable, and it really strains and undermines the credibility of those who claim it will. You know, I could be wrong. Anybody could be wrong about these sorts of things. But logic has to be applied. And when people are making claims that simply don't add up, you need to have the wisdom and the discretion to reject those claims that are false. So, this is just a quickie video, and it shows a really cool applet on the Jet Propulsion Lab website. May the Spirit of God lead you and guide you into all truth. That's why the Comforter was sent. Amen.